Welcome to the Theory of Relativity Simplified. It's a show where we explore the essence of Einstein's theory of special relativity without the complex equations or abstract maths. We simplify the concept but retain its richness and profound implications. I am your host, Jennifer, and joined by my co-host, Inara.
Do check out the complete series for the exciting and mind-boggling world of special relativity.
Introduced by Einstein in 1905, this theory didn't just tweak our understanding of physics, it completely redefined it. Special relativity shattered the idea of absolute time and space, showing us that these aren't fixed, independent entities, but are instead interwoven and dynamic.
It's hard to overstate how radical that idea was. Time and space, the very fabric of our existence, turned out to be interconnected, a single entity called spacetime. It's as if Einstein rewrote the stage on which the entire universe plays out. So special relativity upended centuries of thought, replacing Newton's absolute framework with one where time and space depend on the observer. And the consequences of this shift are profound. It gave us phenomena like time dilation, where time slows down for an object in motion relative to an observer, and length contraction, where moving objects appear shorter along the direction of motion. Simultaneity, how events that seem to happen at the same time for one observer can occur at different times for another. That's mind-bending.
It truly is. These principles not only revolutionized our understanding of motion and time, but also set the stage for even more profound discoveries about the universe. Let's dive into some of those in our last episode of the series. One of special relativity's most significant contributions was the concept of space-time, a four-dimensional continuum that unifies three dimensions of space with time. In this framework, time isn't separate from space, but is fundamentally linked to it.
So every event in the universe has coordinates in both space and time.
That's a great way to think about it. Space-time doesn't just describe where something is, but when it is as well. And the way objects move through space-time depends on their relative motion. This idea has profound implications for how we perceive reality. It means there's no single universal clock ticking away the same for everyone. Instead, time flows differently depending on how you're moving. However, special relativity assumes space-time is flat, and that we're dealing with inertial frames of reference, scenarios where objects move in straight lines at constant speeds without external forces acting on them. These assumptions make the mathematics elegant and the concepts manageable, but they also impose limitations. And that brings us to one of the key limitations of special relativity. It doesn't account for gravity or acceleration. Gravity, as Newton understood it, was a force acting at a distance. But Einstein suspected there was more to the story. Special relativity couldn't explain how gravity fits into the picture, nor could it handle accelerating frames of reference.
So while special relativity gives us a powerful framework, it's not the whole story. It's like a zoomed-in map, accurate for small local regions, but not for the larger landscape.
Exactly. Special relativity works beautifully for describing motion in flat space-time, but it leaves open the question of what happens when space-time itself isn't flat, when it's curved by the presence of mass or energy. And that's where Einstein's next leap, general relativity, comes in. Special relativity laid the groundwork, but general relativity built on it to create a truly revolutionary view of the cosmos. General Relativity is a theory of gravitation that was developed by Albert Einstein between 1907 and 1915. And today we'll explore how Einstein expanded his ideas of special relativity to include gravity, creating a framework that explains phenomena from black holes to the bending of starlight. In special relativity, space-time is flat, a smooth, unchanging backdrop where objects move in straight lines unless acted upon by external forces. But Einstein realized this model couldn't account for gravity. Instead, he proposed that space-time is not fixed. It bends and curves in response to the presence of mass and energy.
So gravity isn't a force pulling objects together, it's the curvature of space-time guiding their paths?
Exactly. Imagine space-time as a flexible fabric. When you place a massive object, like a star or a planet, onto this fabric, it creates a dimple or a curve. Smaller objects, like satellites or asteroids, follow the curves in this fabric, not because they're being pulled by a force, but because they're moving along the natural paths created by space-time itself.
So the moon orbits Earth, not because Earth is pulling it, but because Earth is bending space-time and the moon is following that curve?
Exactly. This was a complete departure from Newton's view of gravity as a force. Einstein's insight was that mass and energy tell space-time how to curve, and space-time tells objects how to move. When special relativity describes space-time as locally flat, it acts as an approximation in small regions where gravity is negligible. In small, localized regions, like the space around a single spacecraft, space-time is nearly flat, and special relativity's principles hold perfectly. But when you zoom out to include massive objects like stars, planets, or galaxies, the curvature of space-time becomes significant, and general relativity takes over.
And these local regions of flat space-time still follow the rules of special relativity, even within the larger curved space-time?
Precisely. Imagine you're on a hilly landscape. If you focus on a small patch of ground, it looks flat, and you can walk as if it were a flat plane. But when you step back and view the whole landscape, you see the hills and curves. Space-time works the same way. Locally, it's flat enough for special relativity to apply. Globally, the curvature created by mass and energy requires the broader framework of general relativity. Einstein's reimagining of gravity as the warping of space-time was nothing short of revolutionary. It not only explained the motion of planets and stars, but also predicted phenomena like the bending of light by gravity, an idea confirmed by the famous solar eclipse observations of 1919. General relativity explains phenomena that are hard to explain otherwise. Let's start with gravitational time dilation and how gravity reshapes our experience of time itself. Imagine standing on the surface of a massive planet where the gravitational pull is strong. Time, as you experience it, moves more slowly compared to someone farther away from the planet's surface, where gravity is weaker. This effect is called gravitational time dilation, and it's one of the key predictions of general relativity.
So when gravity curves space-time, it changes how time itself flows?
Exactly. The stronger the gravitational field, the slower time moves relative to regions with weaker gravity. This has real-world implications, especially for technologies like GPS. Satellites orbiting Earth experience weaker gravity compared to us on the surface, so their clocks tick slightly faster. Without correcting for this, GPS systems would drift substantially.
How does gravity affect light? Does it alter any of light's properties?
This actually brings us to gravitational frequency shift. Light escaping a strong gravitational field loses energy, causing its frequency to decrease and its wavelength to stretch. This is known as redshift. Conversely, light falling into a gravitational field gains energy, shifting to higher frequencies, or blue shifting. These effects have been observed in starlight and are essential for studying massive cosmic objects. Another dramatic prediction of general relativity is the deflection of light by gravity. When light passes near a massive object, like a star or galaxy, the curvature of space-time bends its path. This phenomenon was famously confirmed during the 1919 solar eclipse, when starlight passing near the sun was observed to shift position.
Wasn't that experiment the one that made Einstein a household name?
It definitely made him famous. The deflection of light has even more profound implications. It's the foundation of a magnificent phenomenon called gravitational lensing, where massive objects like galaxy clusters act as cosmic magnifying glasses, bending and amplifying light from distant sources. This effect allows us to study galaxies and phenomena that would otherwise be too faint to observe. An associated phenomena is something called gravitational time delay. When light or signals pass near a massive object, it takes longer to traverse the curved spacetime around it. This delay was first observed using radar signals sent to Venus, and it's now a critical tool for testing general relativity and studying massive celestial bodies. Perhaps one of the most exciting confirmations of general relativity came in 2015, when the LIGO Observatory detected gravitational waves for the first time. These are ripples in spacetime produced by massive accelerating objects like merging black holes or neutron stars.
Ripples in spacetime, that's such a poetic description. But what exactly are these gravitational waves?
Imagine dropping a pebble into a pond. The ripples that spread outward are analogous to gravitational waves, except they travel through spacetime itself. When two massive objects spiral toward each other and merge, they create disturbances that propagate outward at the speed of light. LIGO detected these waves as tiny, almost imperceptible stretches and compressions of space. It was a monumental achievement, earning the 2017 Nobel Prize in Physics. Gravitational waves have opened a new window into the cosmos, allowing us to observe events like black hole mergers that were previously invisible. They also confirm predictions of Einstein's theory with stunning precision, including the spiral chirps of merging black holes. Speaking of black holes, general relativity predicts these enigmatic objects as regions of space-time where gravity is so strong that not even light can escape. At the heart of a black hole lies the event horizon, the boundary beyond which nothing can return. Inside the event horizon, space-time is curved to such extremes that all paths lead inexorably to the singularity, a point of infinite density. Black holes are among the most extreme predictions of general relativity, and their existence has been confirmed through observations such as gravitational lensing, orbital mechanics, and, most strikingly, direct imaging.
And didn't we recently capture an image of a black hole?
We did. In 2019, the Event Horizon Telescope captured the first ever image of a black hole, revealing the glowing ring of material surrounding its event horizon. This was a stunning confirmation of general relativity's predictions. Observations also show that black holes power some of the most energetic phenomena in the universe, such as quasars and relativistic jets. The mergers of black holes produce some of the strongest gravitational waves we can detect, providing insights into their properties and even serving as standard sirens for measuring cosmic expansion. Finally, let's talk about the big picture, literally. One of the most profound implications of general relativity is the concept of cosmic expansion. Einstein's equations predict that space-time isn't static. It can stretch or contract. When astronomer Edwin Hubble observed that galaxies are moving away from us, it confirmed the universe is expanding. Observations of distant supernovae in the 1990s revealed that the universe's expansion isn't slowing down as expected. It's speeding up. This acceleration is attributed to dark energy, a mysterious force that makes up about 70% of the universe. While we don't yet understand its nature, it's a testament to general relativity's power that it predicted a dynamic universe capable of such phenomena.
It's humbling to think how much we owe to general relativity, our understanding of time, light, gravity, and even the fate of the universe.
Absolutely. Einstein's insights transformed physics, opening new ways to explore the cosmos. As we near the conclusion of our series, it's impossible not to reflect on the man behind the theories, Albert Einstein. Over a century after his groundbreaking work on relativity, Einstein's influence remains as profound as ever, shaping not only physics, but also our broader understanding of the universe and our place within it. When Einstein published his theory of special relativity in 1905, it said that only a handful of people in the world truly understood it. One of them was Sir Arthur Eddington, who famously quipped, "Who's the third?" The radical nature of Einstein's ideas, challenging centuries of Newtonian physics, meant they were initially met with skepticism. But Einstein didn't stop there. A decade after special relativity, he introduced general relativity, redefining gravity not as a force, but as the curvature of spacetime. This was a leap even more audacious, requiring a complete reimagining of how the universe operates. Albert Einstein's contributions weren't limited to relativity. His work on the photoelectric effect laid the groundwork for quantum mechanics, earning him the Nobel Prize in 1921. He showed that light behaves as both a wave and a particle, a duality that remains central to modern physics.
And yet Einstein was famously uneasy with quantum mechanics, wasn't he? Didn't he once say, "God does not play dice"?
He did. Einstein struggled with the probabilistic nature of quantum mechanics, which he saw as incomplete. His debates with Niels Bohr on the nature of reality are legendary. Despite this tension, his contributions to quantum theory were foundational. Beyond his scientific achievements, Einstein became a symbol of intellectual freedom and humanism. His pacifism, his advocacy for civil rights, and his deep commitment to education and exploration have left an indelible mark.
And still, he was a portrait of modesty. I understand that he once said, "I have no special talents. I am only passionately curious." And to me, that quote captures the essence of Einstein's approach to life and science. His curiosity drove him to question the fundamental nature of reality. It's why he remains an inspiration, not only to a generation of physicists, but to anyone who values creativity and critical thinking.
True that. As we reflect on 110 years of relativity, it's remarkable how Einstein's work continues to evolve. General relativity remains the framework for understanding gravity, and its predictions have been confirmed time and again, from the bending of light to the detection of gravitational waves. Relativity has also provided the foundation for technologies we rely on daily, like GPS, and opened entirely new fields of research, from black hole physics to cosmology. Even today, scientists are building on Einstein's ideas, seeking to unify relativity with quantum mechanics in the quest for a theory of everything. As we conclude this series, we hope it's inspired you to see the universe through new eyes. Relativity isn't just a theory, it's a way of thinking, a lens that helps us unravel the mysteries of space, time, and beyond.
And while this series comes to an end, the adventure doesn't stop here. Physics is filled with fascinating ideas, from the quantum world to the vastness of the cosmos, and there's so much more to explore.
We encourage you to stay curious. Dive into other areas of physics, astronomy, and even the intersections of science with philosophy and art. The Turing app is full of resources to fuel your exploration, with more topics waiting to spark your imagination.
It's been such a privilege to journey through relativity with you, and we hope you've enjoyed it as much as we have. Thank you for joining us on this incredible ride. Stay curious, stay inspired, and keep asking the big questions. After all, as Einstein himself said, the important thing is not to stop questioning. Until next time, thank you for listening, and here's to the joy of discovery.